In this video, you are going to learn how animations work in Unreal Engine, how they are created, as well as playing them and other cool stuff like using materials as animations. If that sounds interesting, let's get right into it. Most animations in Unreal take place inside the Widget class, which is what we will cover today. So let's create one and add an element such as an image to get access to animations. Then in the bottom left, create an animation, select the image, right-click in the timeline and add the image. The canvas slot type gives you access to certain special properties, but that's not important for now. What is important though is the timeline where the magic happens. Animations in Unreal work under the commonly used principle of keyframes. Keyframes represent a certain state of an element at a given time. Put simply, a keyframe represents the value of something before and after. In between these keyframes, the element will be animated, like repositioning this image linearly or smoothly, but more on that in just a bit. The timeline is basically a container for these keyframes. Animations can happen over time, such as changing the rotation, or instantaneously, like changing its visibility. There are many more properties that can be changed and animated, and you can recognize those by checking for this icon next to any property in the Details tab, which you can also press to immediately add to the timeline. So let's put this into practice. I'm going to move the image from the left side to the right side, and I'm also going to rotate it. So let's go to the timeline, to our image and click on track, and from this menu let's get transform. Now we will be able to transform the translation, rotation, scale and shear. Now make sure that every time you change something and you want to commit to it, that you add a new keyframe by pressing on these buttons. As well, you can also toggle this right here, which is going to automatically create new keyframes every time you change something. Now let's make sure that we have keyframes in the beginning, and after 1 second, I'm going to go to translation and move the X to a higher value, let's say 600. Then let's go to rotation and I'm going to rotate this 180 degrees. Now if I'm going to play this, you should see the image go from left to right and also rotate. Now we have a very basic animation, but this is only the beginning. Alright, now we know how to create animations, but currently they're pretty boring, aren't they? How about we spice things up by adding some interpolation? This will let us ease in the animation, or ease out, or even both. So to do that, select the keyframes you want to change the interpolation to, right-click and select any of the cubic ones for smooth interpolation. And while sometimes this can be enough, more often than not you will want to freely control how things speed up or down, start, stop or pause. And you can do just that by opening the sequencer curves. From here, you can edit the curve of the animation however you want by moving the keyframes tangents around. What I highly recommend is setting the keyframes to weighted tangents to get maximum control. Now we can replicate that previous ease in and out and change it as we see fit. On a related note, if you want to learn more about slowing in and out, make sure to watch this awesome video by Daniel Floyd from New Frame Plus. I had a blast watching it, and if you're interested in this kind of stuff, definitely give it a try. There is gonna be a link in the description. Back to the video, using the sequencer curves is usually very useful for more complex animations, so let's take a look at that now. Taken from the Mario Party's Bopping Spree recreation, this is one of the animations I use to give feedback to the player that they scored a point. While this is still not very complex, it surely is different from the previous square. Let us take a look at what happens throughout this duration. So the first thing that happens in this animation is that it is fading in and also moving upwards. This is going to give it a feel of dynamism. Now in order to make this more interesting, we are also rotating the characters. This pretty much completes the initial upward movement and makes it feel like a jump. Right, you can see how these basically jump upward. There is no way to automatically rotate these characters in such a manner, so you'll have to do this manually. Then after half a second in which the text is stationary, so the player has time to read, it is going to start fading out and moving upwards. But this time we are not going to introduce any rotation. This is still a pretty simple animation, but it is much better than having the text pop out of nowhere. Now let's take a look at another animation. The first thing that takes place is that these two progress bars are going to start filling in. Then they are going to fade out in favor of the notification itself. The glowing lines aren't actually animated in the widget, but more on that later. Then after a whole second and a half, the notification is going to fade back out. Again, still pretty simple, but I hope you can see how this is going to scale for even more complex animations. But how do we play these animations? That is done through code, and I will show you two ways of playing animations. Now let's go back to our original animation. If we are going to head over to the graph, we will be able to see that our animation is now a variable. And now accessing this, we will be able to play it in various ways. So let's get a custom event and I will call this play animation. And to play it once, frankly, you just have to call play animation from the variable. Now things get a bit more complicated when we want to queue animations. So I'll get another custom event and I will call this queue animation. Now let's get this variable again, and from here I will check if it is playing. But before checking with the branch if this is true or not, I'm going to negate it. This way, when the animation is not going to be playing, this is going to return true, otherwise it is going to return false. And if it is true, I'm going to call playAnimation. And from false, what I'm going to do is get a delay with a duration of 0.1. And once this is completed, I'm going to once again check if this is true or false. So this is basically a loop that is going to happen every 0.1 seconds until this condition is going to be true. Now there is one thing with this system that you should know. This is only going to work if you queue two animations at once. If you want to queue more at the same time, it is not going to work properly. For that, you will have to develop a system that is going to keep count of how many times it was called and with what information. That should not be too hard to develop, but if you have any problems, make sure to let me know down below. But animations can also be created outside the widget editor and then added to a widget by creating materials. While materials are mostly used for in-game meshes, they can also be assigned to image accepting properties such as an image. So let's recreate this effect and display it on the UI. So inside the material, the first thing that you want to do is to go to your main node, then go to material domain and choose user interface. Now for this material in particular, we will have to also choose translucent mode. Now in order to actually see this, let's go to final color and choose white. So now we can actually see something on the left side. So firstly, I'm going to get a parameter called size, and its default value is going to be 0.5. Now I'm going to multiply this with a number, and this number should be somewhere around 0.95. And then using this, I'm going to set the radius of a radial gradient exponential. So let's get one, and then plug this inside the radius. Then in density, I would like this to be pretty dense, let's go with 10. And this is going to give us this neat radial gradient. Now we are going to add something to this, but first let's plug this in opacity. Now we are still going to see that white square because B is 1, so let's see how we are going to set that one up. Let's copy this a couple of times and then set the density of the third one to 50. Then I'm going to get the size and multiply it with 0.8. I will plug size inside the radius of the second one and this inside the radius of the third one. Then from the second one, I'm going to subtract the third one. And this is going to give us a hollow ring. Then this is going to be multiplied with something that is going to be the actual movement of the animation and then add it to our initial radial gradient. And then out of nowhere, everything is going to look clean and we will also have a noise texture that looks like this. Now we will want to move this over time, so let's get the panner and plug this in the UVs. Then in coordinate, get texture coordinates and plug this in here. And then in time, obviously, we are going to get time and plug this in here. Now for the speed, I only want this to move upwards, so I'm going to choose 0.5. And if I'm going to preview this now, it should be moving. Now, if I'm going to plug this inside the multiply node, we should see something pretty strange. So what we are doing is basically combining the hollow ring with this moving texture. And then if I'm going to stop previewing this, you should be able to see the animation that you saw in the beginning. The only thing that is missing is an actual image or texture. Then what we can do is open a widget, then go to this material, select it, then select this image, go to brush, image, and click on this arrow. And as you can see now, this is going to be animated. And obviously, you can still animate this inside the widget. So if I'm going to play this animation, you will see it move from left to right. If you liked this tutorial, then make sure to subscribe to stay up to date with other videos and hit that bell if that's your thing. As well, consider supporting my work over on Patreon like this kind folks. Afirama FM, Badr Al-Kakhtani, Etiosa Odia, Giovanni Pena, Golden Glowmaster, Leonardo Pereira, Luke Shargers, Realitats Verlust, and Taman Gering. And let me know in the comments, what do you like more, easing in or easing out? Can't wait to hear your answers. Now make sure to go and watch this tutorial to learn more about UI. Thank you for watching and I will catch you in the next video.